Shoulder front raises. So this is a unique exercise in the sense that it's often done incorrectly. And the biggest reason why I find people do exercises incorrectly is because they confuse the name of the exercise with how the exercise should be done. While it may sound logical that the name of the exercise is a big indicator of the execution of it, it's not often the case. And especially with something like a side lateral raise, where we don't want to go directly to the side, so then it starts to confuse people about the direction the arm should go. So we understand that the line of force, which is the direction the weight is loaded, should be challenging the muscle that you're working or the direction that the muscle fibers contract. So that might be a bit confusing for you, so don't worry too much if you don't get it. Doesn't really matter so much for the purpose of this video. So what I want you to do is for a shoulder front raise, people often do them as a side lateral raise without even realizing because they bring the arms up like this. So if your arms are like this when you're doing this exercise, that's a side lateral raise, even though your hands are directly to the front. What makes it a side lateral raise is not the direction your arms are going, but the muscle that's on top of the joint is the one that dictates which muscles are being worked. So as soon as I internally rotate my shoulder like this, the side delt is on top of the joint. Therefore, it has mechanical advantage to pull the arm up. The shoulder muscle that's on the front, the anterior delt or the front delt, is now on the side of the joint right here. The muscle that contracts this way in this plane is gonna be this way. It's not gonna pull the arm up this way. So what's pulling the arm up is the side delt, even though your arm is directly to the front. So the way we fix that is by externally rotating your shoulders so that the front delt is now on top of the joint here and it has mechanical advantage to pull the arm upward. So when you're looking at a joint, no matter what exercise you're doing, even if it's a glute exercise or a hip exercise, you wanna look at what muscle has mechanical advantage relative to the plane of resistance, the direction the muscle fiber is contracting, relative to the challenge of the load or the challenge of the resistance. So I'm gonna bring the arm up, and as you can see, I'm not doing this because that makes it a side delt raise, even though my arms are coming to the front. So I'm going this direction, and it's a lot more challenging. I'm a lot more weaker, as you can see, relative to this. You see that? There, and now look at how easy this is compared to that, because my side delt is a lot bigger of a muscle and it's a lot stronger than my front delt. Now I'm gonna make one more adjustment when you do this exercise. Instead of coming straight up here, the position of the shoulder is good in terms of the rotation, but I wanna come out to the side slightly. And the reason why I wanna come out to the side is because that allows me to fully contract the front delt. And there you go, that's your front dumbbell raises.